Hey, who doesn't like a cold beer every now and then? Everyone has their favorites, from ales to stouts, from lager to porters. And we like ours with a crab cake. Today on This Crab Cake, we're joined by some of the beer gurus, or as we call them, brewers, from Katcef Brothers. And we're going to talk, you guessed it, beer.
All right, it is, my gosh, it's like June. It's almost technically summer, and we are on the phone with our friends up at Katcef Brothers. We have Cassie joining us, as we do every month, along with Lauren, Bill, and we do have a special guest joining us from Devil's Backbone, Bobby Rohla. How are you guys doing?
Hey, great. Thanks for having us again.
Yeah, good. Fantastic.
I can't believe summer is almost here. It's, you know, the spring was a non-spring, but now it's we're into summer. It's going to be summer in a couple days when we're recording this, and I know we're in the midst of Pride Month, and I remember last year we had a big parade and a festival and everything else, which has all been postponed because of COVID, but definitely been hitting the Bud Light for me, because it's summer, and that's what I do.
I'll say I've been hitting the Babe for me. The wine is feeling pretty good these days, and the cans specifically.
And that's how old is that now for you? Is that like 3 years old now?
This is year three. Yeah, this is year three. Isn't that crazy? I know.
And that has a third type of a flavor, if you will, right? They've got they used to have just like a red and then a white.
So it used to be the rosé and the Pinot Grigio, and then we introduced the red, which is a sparkling red blend over the winter, which was an awesome addition and helped us get that kind of red wine drinker involved too, because if you don't like rosé and you don't like white wine, you know, we didn't really have anything for that drinker, so the red is the red's a nice little touch.
Bill, what's on your June summer beer menu?
I don't know. There's so many things coming out that it's very hard to pick. I don't know. I really like the Orange Smash that's coming out from Devil's Backbone a lot.
Yeah, those RTDs, I think, are capturing a lot of our personal dollars for drinks this summer. I think a lot of those are going to RTDs.
You know, I'll tell you what, let's peel back the curtain a little bit here, because you guys are throwing out these acronyms here for RTD, and that means what? Ready to drink?
Ready to drink. It's a ready to drink cocktail in a can.
Well, that's, and those have been just huge lately. I mean, you going from like the wine in the can to, I mean, it used to be just beer. Face it. That was about it.
So there's a ton. Cutwater's another one that we kind of paved the way for in this category that we picked up earlier, kind of in this wave. And now that Devil's Backbone has jumped on board, theirs are absolutely fantastic. And that's why we have Bobby here today, because he's the mastermind behind them, and he's going to talk all of those nitty-gritty details, particularly on that Orange Smash, which is their version of a crush. It is absolutely freaking fantastic.
All right, well, let me interrupt you right there, Lauren, for a second, because I had a friend that was down at Standing Joe's Riverside down in Galesville last weekend. Because he could be, because it's open. It's great. It's out on the water, and it's easy to socially distance and everything else. And they had the Orange Smash, and they were raving about it. I have not tried it yet, so I've got to put that on my list.
Yeah, you need to make a point to try this one. It is absolutely fantastic. The outpouring of support and enthusiasm behind that brand was something we have not seen in a very long time. It's very, very cool. It's an awesome, awesome liquid.
Well, I'll tell you what, why don't we introduce, this is Bobby Rohla. Did I pronounce that name right?
Yeah, it's Bobby Rohla. So yeah, you're very close. It's an unconventional last name.
Fair enough. And you are from Devil's Backbone down in Virginia. Virginia. And
Yeah, we're down in Roseland, Virginia.
Awesome. And, you know, I know you guys from beer, and that's it's kind of exciting that everything is, moving along, and you guys have, I wouldn't say pivoted, but I mean, you're just adapting to the market.
Yeah, I think that's right. We added the distillery back, I think, in 2018, and I came on last year in 2019, and we really started looking at doing these RTD products last year. You know, we had some stuff in market with Katcef, getting a feel for it. And then took another look at how we could get some really good tasting, accessible and fun drinks out. Orange Smash is obviously one of them, and it kind of follows from what we do in beer. We make great tasting stuff, and then we make it available and really put it forward in an accessible fashion so people can have fun with it.
Well, what is the Orange Smash? I mean, you look at an Orange Crush. I mean, I know what's in there. I mean, is this the same type of thing? Or is
it is literally the same thing. So we have a great distiller down here, Matt, and the idea was, how can we make that exact same drink and put it in a can? So you basically go to the recipe, figure out the exact proportions of everything that goes in there. It's primarily triple sec, vodka, orange juice, and, you know, like a citrus soda. We reverse engineered it into a canned cocktail. So it tastes exactly like it should. Absolutely delicious. And, you know, it's a 10% ABV drinker. So it really works well in kind of a fun kind of beach party setting.
Well, it's also got to be perfect for getting out on the bay or poolside.
For sure.
Just because, you know, you don't have to worry about the glass. You don't worry about mixing or anything like that. You just pop the can and go.
Yeah, exactly. We like to think, you know, people can pour it over ice or whatever, but my view right now, people want something that they can, you know, be confident hasn't touched a lot of hands, and they can pull it straight out of their own cooler if need be, crack it open and just enjoy it on the boat, at the pool. There's nothing too fussy about the drink. It's what we love about it.
Any other flavors besides the orange smash?
Yeah, so the orange smash is really going like gangbusters, right? But we have a fantastic vodka mule. I'm really fond of that one. It's made with real ginger juice, so that's something very, very different. We're actually working with a fresh pressed ginger juice. It's amazing stuff. Makes the thing really kind of lively and a bit spicy, but easy to drink. And then we have a vodka soda, which is a vodka soda with lime, really classic. Low calorie, I think it's like 90 calories, 4.5% ABV. So those are really popular, and you can just drink them all day. I might suggest alternating between an orange smash and maybe a vodka soda, and then, of course, a Bud Light or a Natty Light if you're on the boat, but like we're talking Bud Light. And then there is the gin and tonic, which is absolutely beautiful, classic gin and tonic, 7.5%. And those products are all available in the D.C. area, Maryland area, certainly. I think we're down from Georgia up to Maine in various states right now. So it's fun to see it grow.
Well, just curious, because I'm Lauren, you can probably correct me if I'm wrong, or Bill, but the Orange Crush was invented down in Ocean City, Maryland. Is that correct?
Yeah, that's exactly right.
Yeah. Now, so obviously that's somewhat of a regional taste or a drink. I mean, obviously it can be made anywhere, but I mean, are you finding that this market is really the one for Orange Smash, or is it really something more universal?
So we're seeing, like, it's the most popular product, RTD product in every market where we have it. So we thought the same thing, right? Let's it was almost an afterthought, frankly. Let's make something really cool for the Maryland market. They have this really awesome cocktail that everybody enjoys by the beach. Let's do our own take on it. And, you know, come to find out, particularly in Georgia, which is another big market for us right now, the Atlanta area, people just absolutely love this stuff. And it makes sense. It's really a delicious drink. It's easy to drink. Great flavor profile. And it has that awesome crab on the front of it, so it's really fun to see.
You need a peach smash in Georgia.
Definitely. I think we're looking at different flavors as we roll along with this smash category, too. So there's a lot that we can do. Peach makes a lot of sense. We think, you know, we're moving up into some states in the Northeast, so what can we do with that as well? Kind of fruit products or cocktails that make sense and are really super tasty and really, I think, easy to drink, not too complex.
Why did you guys make the shift from beer into this? Is it just because that's what people are drinking?
Not a shift. I think we're adding new products, right? So certainly people are moving towards, you know, we've seen the FMB growth, seltzer growth, and now RTDs this year. I think year over year, these canned cocktails, we have them up like 120-odd% or something like that, total market. So obviously people are moving there. We have the ability to make this stuff in our distilleries. So we thought, let's add to the portfolio, right? We keep doing delicious beer. We have really cool products that are kind of beer adjacent. We have new lighter beers that have a lot more fruit flavors involved with them. And this is kind of an extension of that thinking. And, you know, making drinks that are, I think, easier for certain folks to drink. Maybe they're not beer drinkers, but they love like an easygoing cocktail. And then certainly beer drinkers love a cocktail too.
Makes sense there. But what else is new with Devil's Backbone? What else have you got on the horizon down outside of the Orange Smash and the vodka mules and vodka sodas?
So there's certainly these pieces, and vodka soda is something we're excited about for next year, too. The distillery, that's really my domain here, so I can speak primarily to that. We've started doing some interesting stuff with some whiskeys down here, so we're finally getting into doing some of that, kind of examining the Vienna malt, something that we use in our kind of famous Vienna, you know, lager. And looking at how that might work in a whiskey product. So that's something that I'm really excited about and our distiller's really excited about. We do some amazing gins down here. So if you're out visiting us in the county, in Nelson County, you might be able to pick up some gin or some brandy. So those are products we're working on now. Primary focus has been RTDs. We really are excited about that.
And
of course, the beer. There's some cool stuff for beer coming out. I won't steal our brewer's thunder on that, but could be a really cool fall.
It's going to be a really, really cool fall. We'll talk more about that as we get to get through the summer and start talking about Oktoberfest, but there's some super cool stuff coming from Devils. Yeah, there's going to be some really cool stuff.
It's like a tease, guys.
It's really, really exciting. Yeah, this year, we have some really amazing stuff this year. I'm really kind of blown away with the cool products that we have coming out. Really getting this innovation thing working, and it's really fun to be around here right now. I know it's an interesting time for everybody, but we've been thinking up really cool stuff, and this year, particularly coming to the fall, should be amazing.
Do you guys have tours of the distillery under normal conditions, or if you're doing it now?
So we have a really cool cocktail lounge that's appended to the distillery, and there's these windows that look straight into it, so you can see the whole production process. It's a relatively small space, so if somebody's here and they, want to take a peek, Matt might have him back in. We don't run scheduled tours at this point in time. I think as we come out of this kind of more structured opening up period, so really looking into next year, we're going to re-examine how we do the tours around here and make it more of a regular thing.
No, I mean, I didn't know whether you guys were opened or how that's working down in Virginia. I know it's...
The restaurant, the brew pub, we are open. So consistent with, I think we're phase two down here. So what we can have is outdoor dining. If you've never been down here, we have a huge, beautiful kind of beer field. It's out in beautiful Nelson County. I'm looking out the window right now. We've got a bunch of clouds and stuff, but we're surrounded by mountains and just a giant property with a big kind of open beer field. Great for, dining, drinking, whatever. So we've actually had quite a bit of business going on out here over the last few weeks as people start wading back out.
I'm jealous. I'm looking out my window and looking at a steamroller because they're repaving my street.
John, I can assure you the view is very, very different from a steamroller down at base camp.
Yeah, come out and see us. We are open if you want.
The only thing I'm adverse to the Virginia State Police. Apparently they have an attraction to me, and it's and my daughter who got a reckless driving ticket there one time cost us like $1,100 to get out. Once you hit,
yeah, but get those for speeding? Aren't they
it is. You hit it.
They're pretty liberal with throwing those at you just for speeding.
80 miles.
Yeah, I lived in Virginia for my whole life minus my adult life, and I'm pretty sure I had 6 speeding tickets along 460.
Yeah. Yeah. No. Once you hit,
I might have gotten by with 3 of them.
Nasty is actually a speed demon. Who knew?
I moved from Maryland to Virginia when I was younger. Be with my father for a little bit, and I got 2 reckless driving tickets in a month. From being in Maryland, you're used to driving faster.
Yeah. And
yeah, that's an issue.
Bill, that is far less surprising than Cassie getting a reckless driving ticket. You getting one is far less surprising.
Yeah.
I'll leave it there. I skirted by a few times with some things, but I'll leave it there.
Has nothing to do with your bubbly personality and your bright smile or anything, right, Cass?
I guess I might have known a couple people at a time or two. Managed to get out of that reckless one.
Oh, that's funny. Yeah, no, they're brutal down there. I know as soon as you hit 80, if it's a 70-mile-an-hour thing, as soon as you hit that 11 miles, anything over 10, over 70 reckless. Is reckless. And it's like, whoa. And it's a scam.
And they post it. Yeah, they're trying to make money off everybody's passenger district. That's probably true.
Well, John, when you make your trip down to Devil's Backbone, we'll just have to make sure that it takes you 4.5 hours to get there instead of 4.
I'll just drive my Yugo. It doesn't go over 45.
There you go.
Hold on, wait, you have a Yugo?
Do you have a Yugo?
No, I don't. Although that would be kind of cool.
We can try to get one for you down here. That would be.
It looks
Bill
like...
is just so excited for a second.
Yeah. It's like members only club. You'd be the last member, man. That'd be crazy.
I tell you, man. Well, they looked just like the old rabbits, didn't they?
Yeah, I mean, they were the finest in Yugoslavian imports only. Yeah, they were awesome.
Well, it sounds like there's all sorts of great stuff coming out of Devil's Backbone. The Orange Smash, I haven't tried it, but I have some friends that were raving about it down at Stan and Joe's.
It was a perfect dock drink, they were saying, just to sit out there and watch the day go by.
It's a pretty perfect everything drink. I think all of us have been putting it through its paces a little bit, and I've yet to find something it's not appropriate for.
Well, we're going to keep it coming your way, and you know, it's really, I appreciate what you all are doing to getting behind these fun products. You know, it's always like stepping out with something new, but this one is amazing.
No, I was just going to say, thanks for taking time out of your day to hop on the phone with us, Bobby. It's
I appreciate it.
It's always good to get the talk to the horse's mouth. I guess, is that the word? That's not the right word, but you know, go to the source.
There you go.
What else is going on in the world of Katcef, Cassie?
Well, we have 4th of July coming up, and obviously last month we talked a little bit about Fold of Honor and the Budweiser Patriotic Pack that we have out in the market through the 4th of July. A portion of the proceeds goes directly to the Fold of Honor program, so we just want to remind you guys to support our troops as you celebrate, and always celebrate responsibly.
Bay Ridge Wine and Spirits, which is my liquor store, just opened up to the public again. They used to just be curbside only. So when I was in there the other day, and I did see the Patriot packs all stacked up in their red, white, and blue, and it made an impressive display, much more impressive than calling in and saying, hey, bring me a blue pack out. But it's I know that they're in the stores as well. And 4th of July is certainly going to be a little bit different for everybody this year.
Certainly is.
Has Washington canceled their fireworks? Do you know? I know Annapolis and Baltimore and pretty much Maryland has. I haven't heard anything. At one point I heard that the president was looking to make sure there was something going on the 4th, but I haven't heard any confirmation on that. Have you guys got any scoop on that?
I do not know.
I thought that they were canceled, but now you're making me question myself, John.
John, I would bet money they're canceled.
I would think so, too. But which is going to be kind of a bummer, but that does give you the opportunity to make your own 4th, make your own fun. And it doesn't all need to be about parades and fireworks either. I mean, it's just more about getting together with friends and people that you care about and, just having a good time and celebrating what we are.
Yeah, I think it's going to look a little bit different this year, but I think, we've been through so many months of this now. I think people have gotten pretty good at finding a way to still, enjoy these what little things like this we have, like these little these holidays that, no, you're probably not going to be sitting on the lawn watching all the fireworks, but that doesn't mean that you can't celebrate. So, I think this will be just another opportunity for, the Folds of Honor program and for 4th of July and everything else and all this hard work Cassie's put in over the past few years. The momentum will carry it through, and it's a great program, and 4th of July is 4th of July. It's still a great beer drinking holiday.
That's true. Well, and for those that aren't aware, again, the Folds of Honor program, and please jump in and correct me if I mess this up, but it is a scholarship program for military, for, veterans. Military families to get their kids through school. And it's been something that Budweiser Corporate, as well as Katcef Brothers, has been just so intimately involved with over the years, because it just does so much for the people that have given so much for us. Did I get that right?
It truly does. It truly does. A couple of two of our recipients over the years who we've supported in their scholarship have graduated. And it's exciting to see them move on in such a positive way and to have helped them in their education efforts and to see where they go, career-wise. So that was really exciting to see their graduation, after knowing them for several years too. It touched my heart and obviously our company's heart too, because we knew exactly where the money was going.
Yeah, it's got to be really cool when you sit there and I mean there's so many times where you can write a check for $25 or whatever and you don't know what it does, but I mean on a corporate level to be able to say, okay, hey, I'm gonna take ownership of this child's education or a portion of this child's education and just see where it goes. It's just got to be so rewarding to be able to see that.
Truly is.
I'll tell you, you know what? Another thing that's kind of neat is that in Maryland, we're all starting to reopen. So the bars and the restaurants, not so much the bars as far as being in, but most of the restaurants that have bars can do this outside dining and inside dining limited. So you are able to get out into some of your favorite restaurants to be able to enjoy a meal and certainly a beverage or two. I know I was talking to a friend of mine about going up. Actually, we're going to go up to Langway's tomorrow. It was like, well, you know, we could go back on your deck. I said, no, you know, I want to go someplace where I sit down and I pay a premium to have somebody bring me wings and a beer. I said, I know I can get the same food on my back deck, but I want to be off of my back deck. I've spent way too much time in the last 3 months there. So I'm looking forward to getting out and having some fun as we lead into the 4th of July.
Yeah, that it's funny that you say that because I had I went and met some friends over the weekend up in Frederick, and we stopped at one of the breweries there has a bunch of outdoor space. And so I met them over there, and I was so excited to drink a beer somewhere outside that was not my backyard and tip the bartender an exorbitant amount of money just right. for the absolute joy of getting to sit out there. I was like just so excited to just spend, you know, more on the tip than I did on the beer and sit there and enjoy the sunshine and have somebody bring the beer to me, draft beer. It was so exciting. You know, I get you on the back deck, not wanting to sit on your back deck anymore.
Oh, it's unreal. It's like, yes, a $19 hamburger. Yes, bring it on. You know what I mean?
It's like, oh my God, all of this overpriced food. This is so great.
Yes, I know I could buy it for $1.99 at the Giant, but dang it all.
The carryout thing has really been kind of fun. Like, I've tried a bunch of places that I otherwise probably never would have gone to eat with all the carryout. And, you know, I've bought cocktails that probably I wouldn't otherwise buy. Like, who can say no to a pouch of margaritas or a canned Orange Crush? Right. You know, so I think I can speak for myself in that it really has kind of expanded my horizons.
I think coming out of this whole thing, you're going to see a lot of changes. I think, first of all, I think curbside and carryout is going to be a permanent thing now. I think that's going to be a significant portion of every restaurant's business. I mean, it used to be just, okay, I need, you know, 10 doggy bags a night or whatever it may be. But now I think that's going to be a significant portion of the restaurant business. But I also think you're going to see a lot of liquor laws changing with delivery of beer. Mm-hmm. I know there's that new app, and I'm sure that you're probably familiar with it, but the Beer Me, which is was done, I think, out in Montgomery County is where it started. To deliver craft brews, breweries can sign up with the app, and they would connect them with people to be in, and they would just handle their own delivery. I mean, within their own specific area. I mean, it's, I think you're going to see a lot of lightening up on the liquor laws and the little changes, certainly here in Maryland, but I think probably nationwide when you sit there and see what problems it didn't cause by lightening it up throughout the last 3 or 4 months.
Yeah. I think everyone was afraid at first that we were going to turn into Vegas. And it was just going to be a free for all of people running around with, you know, yard margaritas or something ridiculous. But I think, I think everybody's, for the most part, been pretty responsible. And we've all been grown up adults about it. And, you know, it's helped keep a lot of businesses afloat. When you step back and look at the number of businesses that probably wouldn't have made it through this crisis without the ability to do those things.
Without a doubt.
It's hard to make a case against it.
No, it really is. And I also think that our society has changed a little bit. I mean, I don't think we live in a world now where it's like, yeah, let's go out and get messed up. And that's the reason to go out. You know, you're going out to socialize. You're going out with friends. You're going out to see things. I mean, I know when my son turned 18 or, whoops, when my son turned 21, I mean, he had it all down. This is how we're going to go. And this is how we're going to go drink safely. You know, we've got our Uber drivers lined up. We've got a designated driver for this and everything else, which is something that I never would have done when I was younger. And I'll,
I think the mentality on that has changed. I think you're totally right.
And I think it's time. I mean, we need to definitely loosen up and, you know, some of these antiquated liquor laws that we've got here, certainly in Maryland. Time to them to go.
When are they going to turn MoCo into a non-control county? That's a question from somebody in the distilled spirits business.
That's a great
Now you're really asking the deep questions, Bobby.
I am also a lawyer, guys, so I get very interested in regulatory stuff.
Bobby, that's the easiest answer in the world. As long as they can find the taxes somewhere else, they don't care. But until they make $40 million from somewhere else, they ain't gonna.
Yeah. I mean, Virginia makes, I was looking at this, they do like over $1 billion in liquor sales, and so much of that is tax out of the VA ABC. It's insane.
The ABCs are interesting. I mean, Pennsylvania, I knew that they had that. I didn't realize that Montgomery County was its own, you know, they handled their own liquor store.
Yeah, they're a weird little anomaly inside of, I mean, I think you've maybe said 17 control states. A lot of them are in, you know, or on the eastern seaboard. So, in the Northeast, and then you have obviously Virginia and North Carolina, Pennsylvania, West Virginia has control. So it changes a lot of what we do on the distilled spirit side that adds a bunch of complexity to really getting product to market.
Well, I'll tell you what, I wish everybody have a great 4th of July, have a safe 4th of July. Last month, actually, we had some, I guess it's antiquated, but called the mail-in rebates that we posted up with this podcast when we went out there to save on some Bud Light Seltzer and stuff like that. Are those still good, Cassie?
They're still good. Rocking and rolling. Save big.
Are there?
So there's a lot of them out there, too. And, you know, they change periodically. So keep an eye out because there are some really great ones out there now. There are some really great ones that are going to be coming on some new packages that we have too. So make sure that you're keeping an eye out for those and checking up on the social media where those are posted.
Where are they posted on social media?
So a lot of the, and Cassie can talk a little bit more about this, but a lot of the retailers have really got behind these and started posting them to their own social media to help get people not only in the door, but help sort of pass that value along. So, you know, definitely your favorite retailer, your favorite wine, beer, liquor store, you know, don't be afraid to ask and keep an eye on their social media. Our social media has a lot of it as well. So lots of places to find them. And then, of course, just in the stores, too, signage and case cards, things like that will be posted next to those items.
Well, I know last month you sent me a couple images that I could include and send out with this thing. Can you do that? Can you hook me up again?
I will hook you up. And those of you out there can follow us at Katcef Brothers Brew.
Well, fantastic. 4th of July coming up very soon, sooner than we really think. You got lots of great stuff for the summer. I mean, you've got Bud Light, my favorite, unapologetically forever. Babe, you've got all sorts of different flavors of wine. This Orange Smash, which I definitely need to get to try out. And I am a fan of gin and tonic, so I'm going to seek out that Devil's Backbone gin and tonic and see what that's all about.
If you're a gin and tonic fan, you'll love it. I'm a big gin and tonic person. It's fantastic.
It is. I mean, you've got the Bud Light Seltzer. You've got the mail-in rebates, which aren't really mail-in rebates, but they're kind of electronically redeemable rebates with QR codes. And again, you know, support the Folds of Honor. I mean, it's a no-brainer to do it. If you buy your Budweiser in a Patriot pack, it will support the Folds of Honor, which is giving scholarships to military families, children in military families, which are really, it's something we really need to do is to support our military. And, you know, Katcef and Budweiser and everybody else obviously realizes that and is taking a frontline position on it. I want to wish everybody a happy 4th, safe 4th. If you go buy your own fireworks, make sure you buy the legal ones wherever you live. And don't lose any thumbs, because thumbs are important.
Thumbs are important.
Yeah, but words of wisdom. I love that.
All righty, guys. Hey, thank you very much.
Thanks for having us, John. Happy 4th.
Thanks for talking to you.
Thank you. Happy 4th.
This Crab Cake has been brought to you by the Maryland Crabs. Full episodes release every Thursday at noon. Please make sure you subscribe and visit us online at themarylandcrabs.com.